Algerians' passion for football is palpable on match days. These celebrations follow a 1-0 win over Togo in an African Cup of Nations qualifier. Fans' relationship with their team hasn't always been this positive, however. And with the crucial World Cup qualifying campaign coming up, this relationship could be put to the test once again. The Desert Foxes have 1 point from 2 matches in a group that includes Nigeria, Cameroon and Zambia. The Chipolopolo are their next challenge in August, and there are high expectations of Spaniard Lucas Alcaraz, who's just beginning his coaching tenure with the Foxes.
We've been struggling to qualify for World Cups. We have the best team in Africa, and the whole world saw that in Brazil when we made it to the knockout stages. I believe our team will return to those levels under Alcaraz.
Alcaraz has brought in 5 young players from local academies, a move which has endeared him to the fans.
Youssef Atal and Rauf Benguit from Paradu Academy are great players. They're being groomed by FA President Zechi, and their inclusion in the team is very encouraging.
It's good that the coach is relying on local talent, because we have good players here in Algeria.
Players are exuding similar levels of confidence, but they are well aware of the challenges.
Still, we have mathematically chance to go, so the next 2 games will be huge for us. They will be so important. I think this is where we need to win those 2 games.
I honestly think our chances for the 2018 World Cup are minimal. We missed a good chance in the first 2 matches. Now there's much to do. In football, though, anything is possible. We have seen great comebacks in this sport, so it's still possible.
Nos chances sont fortement compromises, mais enfin.
The current crop of players is considered Algeria's second golden generation, after the first one, which reached 2 consecutive World Cups in the 80s. Now the country hopes that this group of talented players can make even more history by reaching a 3rd consecutive World Cup in Russia next year. Celestine Karoney, CGTN, in Algiers, Algeria.